What do we mean by destructive and non-destructive editing? These terms actually apply to a bunch of different types of editing, editing photos, editing videos. But of course, I'm going to stick to what I know and talk about destructive and non-destructive editing in audio. That said, this distinction between destructive and non-destructive editing is the same for all of these different types of editing. With non-destructive editing, we're doing editing where the original content is not modified in the course of editing. Instead, information about the edits is stored and interpreted by software. So, for example, most of the operations we'll do in a DAW, a digital audio workstation, will be non-destructive. We'll have our audio files, and then rather than making direct edits to those audio files, those multiple tracks, when we cut them and reorder them, the original file stays the same, but the DAW, the software, is remembering what edits you've made and storing those in the file. This is called an edit decision list, an EDL. So this is storing information on a timeline about what part of the original file is played, at what time, at what volume, etc. So in general, your DAW will have a DAW-specific file, which is this EDL, this edit decision list, and other information about your session, and then the audio will be stored separately. In the case of Logic, sometimes it stores this inside of a package, but those original audio files exist outside of the DAWs file. By contrast, in destructive editing, portions cut from the audio are cut. You can think about how edits used to be done on tape. You actually had to cut out a portion of tape, and then to reorder it, you would physically reorder it. This is changing that original material. So why use either? Well, in the case of our DAW, when we're doing multi-tracking, it can be incredibly useful to keep that original file and just store this list of edits. It'll mean that the original file is always there for us to draw on it if we need it. So, in contrast, why would you ever want to then do destructive editing? Destructive editing is great for working directly with the sound materials. Perhaps it's not quite as useful when doing multi-tracking, but, for example, I use destructive editing when I'm doing my sample editing, preparing sounds for samplers or for playback in video games, because I work directly with the sound file, and I can see immediately what's happening to that audio file. Destructive editing can also be useful for things like noise removal and printing other effects to tracks. If you keep layering on effects and effects and effects in non-destructive editing, you might put demands on your computer's processing power. And when you're working with the final files for distribution, mastering, you'll often be doing destructive editing too, working directly with that waveform. Now, of course, when you use destructive editing, it's good to have a backup. So even though you're doing destructive editing, you still take the responsibility to hold on to the original yourself. It's worth noting that some operations you do in a DAW will be destructive, altering that original waveform. And it's important to understand that when you apply them. So, as with everything, it's not a do this, not this. It's a matter of understanding how destructive and non-destructive editing work, whether you're making changes to the original file or not, and then deciding which of these is most effective for what you're trying to accomplish.